with his foot, a spring gushed, water, cold water, started gushing from his feet. Allah says, هَذَا مُغْتَسَلٌ بَارِدٌ وَشَرَابٌ. This is cold water for you to wash yourself with and to drink. So as he washed, his blisters started disappearing. As he drank, the internal organs came in order again. To the degree that in a short space of time, his skin was renewed totally. Renewed totally. A new man. Allahu Akbar. And his internals were made again as good as they were before, and even better by drinking this water. My beloved brothers and sisters, we also have water similar to that. We have a gift of Zamzam. We have the well in Makkah al-Mukarramah. Remember, it serves the same purpose. The hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, Zamzam is for whatever intention it is drunk with and for. So if you're drinking it with the intention, Ya Allah, cure me, Ya Allah, this, Ya Allah, it will inshallah serve that purpose. For as long as you have that yaqeen and conviction in your heart, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us from that gift. We don't take Zamzam for granted. Wallahi, it is water that is a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This particular water was different from Zamzam, but it served similar purpose. Where he got cure, and amazingly, when his wife came back, she looked and she says, where is Ayyub? Who are you? But you look very similar to him. MashaAllah. He says, I am Ayyub. Allah granted me cure. Now there was a time, according to one narration, there was a time when the people around him were saying, Allah doesn't love this man. If Allah loved him, this wouldn't have happened to him at that time. And he continued, he says, never. I know that when Allah tests a person, He tests him this way as well. And he continued and he persevered. So Allah says, we tested him one, we tested him two, we tested him three with the most difficult tests. And he passed one, he passed two, he passed three. Then Allah says, okay, here's your dua, here's your water as a gift, just by striking your foot on the ground. Subhanallah. Then Allah says, وَوَهَبْنَا لَهُ أَهْلَهُ وَمِثْلَهُمْ مَعَهُمْ رَحْمَةً مِنَّا وَذِكْرَى لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. After that, not only did we return his health to him, but his family, we gave back family members double than what he had before. In a short space of time, Allah says, we gave him double what he had before. And Allah says, we gave it to him as a blessing from us and as a reminder for those with sound intellect, those who want to take heed. Now how do we take heed? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a lesson. When Allah has tested you, when you are patient, the reward of that sabr is so great that there is no ways I can describe it to you. Allah says, إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Allah recompenses the one who engages in patience and sabr in a way that is unlimited. Unlimited. It is reported that when a person is sick and ill and they are patient about it and they continue, and if they die in that condition, or when a person who was sick happens to die on the day of Qiyamah, when they see the reward that they accumulated solely by sitting and being patient, they will say, why didn't you keep us sick all our lives? We could have accumulated much more. So don't lose hope when you have a slight sickness here or there, terminal or not. We ask Allah to grant shifa to all those who are sick. Yes, it is an act of worship to go and seek cure. But at the same time, it is also an act of worship whilst the cure is being sought, that we bear patience. The same applies when you've lost your loved ones. Look at Ayyub alayhi salam. He lost all his children, all of them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we gave him a gift. We gave him his children and we multiplied them by two. A gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine. Allahu Akbar. Look at this gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we have lost a loved one, remember one thing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you so much goodness in return. So much that we cannot describe it. Allah says, بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Without limits, unlimited reward you will receive. But don't question the decree of Allah. Ya Allah, you took my child away. Why? No, don't ask Allah why. Say, Ya Allah, say what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. He held his son Ibrahim whilst this ruh was being taken away.
And a tear rolled down the eyes of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Sahaba radiallahu anhum are watching. And he looks and he says,
إِنَّ لِلَّهِ مَا أَخَذَ وَلَهُ مَا أَعْطَى وَكُلُّ شَيْءٍ عِنْدَهُ بِأَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى.
He says, definitely, for Allah is what He has taken away, and it belonged to Him in the first place anyway. And He says, everything has a fixed time. And the Sahaba radiallahu anhum asked Him, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we see you are crying, we see a tear rolling. He says, I'm not questioning the will of Allah. We are happy at the decree of Allah. But these tears, إِنَّمَا هِيَ رَحْمَةٌ جَعَلَهَا اللَّهُ فِي عِبَادِهِ الرُّحَمَى. This is a sign of mercy that Allah has placed in the hearts of those who have a little bit of mercy. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to distinguish between the tears of sorrow that we are going to miss someone and so on, and that tears of mercy, and on the other hand, tears of anger and being upset with the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May we never be on that condition. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, He now returned the health of Ayyub alayhi salam. And as he is bathing, and this hadith is in Sahih al-Bukhari, as he is bathing, without his clothes on, he's bathing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent locusts that fell from heaven, from Jannah. And they came, pure gold locusts falling. Pure gold. This is a sahih, correct narration. And he started gathering them. And he was thankful to Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks him, Oh Ayyub, you know we will take care of you. Why are you gathering these locusts? He says, Ya Allah, this is mercy from you. I must gather it. Subhanallah. So Allah restored his wealth in a miraculous way. Health in a miraculous way. Wealth in a miraculous way. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him children again in a miraculous way. Subhanallah. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, he had one issue, one more issue. He swore that he would lash his wife 100 lashes if he was cured. Now he's cured. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to him, وَخُذْ بِيَدِكَ ضِغْثًا فَاضْرِبْ بِهِ وَلَا تَحْنَثْ. Allah says, don't break your promise. We will show you a way out. You can take a little bunch full of grass-like branch, very light, and use that to whip, Allah says. So imagine now you're taking a bundle of little grass and you're using that. It has no pain, but you are not breaking your promise. Look how Allah taught him a way out of this. Because he was genuine. He did not make a qasam for some silly reason, but it was because of Allah and because of his love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah showed him a way out. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show us also ways out of our problems and messes. Subhanallah. Sometimes really we have caused our own mess, and sometimes we are stuck in it. Believe me, this is the month of Ramadan. If you are sincere and you want to come out of your mess, wallahi you can walk straight out of it by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just call out to Allah and head back to the straight path, and you see how the doors will swing open one after the other. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of that. Then at the end Allah says, Allahu Akbar.
Inna wajadnahu sabira ni'mal abdu innahu awwab.
We found him to be very patient. What an excellent worshipper of ours. Indeed, he was oft returning to us. Look at Allah praising Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam. Now for Allah to say we found him patient, imagine what type of test he must have been through. When Allah declares, this slave of ours was an excellent worshipper. He was so patient. We tested him and we found him to be patient. And Allah says, innahu awwab. The word awwab means one who constantly returns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything he returns to Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who return to him at all times. So that was Ayyub alayhi salatu wasalam. It is reported that he lived for many years, 93 years. Some say he had 26 children and so on. All these figures, we actually do not have them from solidly authentic narrations. So we will not make mention of the details of it. But we do know in a nutshell, Allah blessed him in such a great way. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us too. But remember, for the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to come in our direction, we need to also strive and struggle, bear patience, and you need to know that not every day will be rosy. One day you will have difficulty, one day you will have ease. يَوْمٌ لَكَ وَيَوْمٌ عَلَيْكَ. A day for you and a day against you. One day will be in your favor, the other day will be against you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about it in the Quran.
فَأَمَّا الْإِنسَانُ إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ رَبُّهُ فَأَكْرَمَهُ وَنَعَّمَهُ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَكْرَمًا وَأَمَّا إِذَا مَبْتَلَاهُ فَقَدَرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقَهُ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّي أَهَانًا كَلَّا.
Allah says, as for man, when we grant him, when we give him, by testing him, or in order to test him, we give him a lot. And thereafter he says, oh, my Lord has honored me. And when we start taking things away in order to test him, he says, my Lord has let me down, he's disgraced me. Allah says, nay, that's not correct. Allah tests you. If you have a business, you have to suffer a loss one day. It cannot be profit all the way down. No. Allah says, we want to see, can you adjust your life once again to what it used to be many years ago? And still thank Allah to say, I still got more than what I used to have 30 years back. Allahu Akbar.
Let's move to another prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The prophet Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam. He's also known as the Noon. Why is he known as the Noon? Because a Noon would mean the big fish. So he is the companion of the fish, or of the whale, the huge fish. What happened to him? A beautiful story, amazing story. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the prophet Yunus, in English we would say Jonah, may peace be upon him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent this prophet to certain people. It is reported close to Iraq or within Iraq, within what we know as Iraq. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructed him to guide these people, to call them towards Allah and to warn them of the previous punishments and to tell them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can send you this punishment and that punishment, and he can send you in the same way he sent the previous nations and so on. And he started his work as a Nabi of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he worked. And he started calling his people. They were just more than 100,000 people. And he started calling his people, but they were not listening to him. And he got irritated with them in the sense that his patience was running out. They started saying things and exactly how the others used to do, they started doing. So he decided, you know what? I'm not winning with these people. Let me go away. I might find other people somewhere very, very far away, and I might call them and they might come in to the fold. They might listen. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had not instructed him to go away, but he wanted to go to spread the deen because he really wanted people to accept, and nobody was accepting. So that irritation made him go. So as he went, he decided, right, I'm upset, I'm angry, I'm going. And I'm going so far that I want to jump into a ship and I want to go somewhere far away, over, across the ocean, across the sea. So as he arrived at the coast, there was a laden boat which was now going. He jumped into it and he was gone. It had goods. And suddenly, mashallah, they went into the sea, and then the wind started blowing. And then the storm started gathering, meaning, subhanallah, the ship started rocking. And after a while it started sinking. And when it started sinking, the people decided we need to get rid of our goods to make it light. So they started throwing, one by one, the goods, everything went out. Everything was gone. The ship is still sinking. The boat is still sinking. We don't know the exact size of it, but it was laden. By this time, all the goods were out. Now they looked at the people. They said, there's only one way of being fair. We need to draw lots. We need to draw lots. Now drawing lots meaning they had their own system, whether it was, you know, whatever dice or whatever it was, whether they put the names in a hat and picked out one, whatever it was, they decided we are going to choose this method, and whoever's name comes, we're throwing him out one by one. So they gathered everything, they picked out first person's name, Yunus. They looked at him, they said, no, this is a good man and he's a blessed man. And he's, you know, really an asset to the people on this boat. So let's try again. So now they tried again. When they tried again, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes mention of this in the Quran. When they tried again, amazingly they picked out the name. Again it was his name. They looked at him, they said, no, can't be. Let's try again, third time. So they're trying again, third time. And after they picked the name out, they saw it was his name for the third time. So they looked at him, they said, okay, that's it, sorry, but you're going to have to jump off. So in the middle of the sea, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, and he jumped out. And as he jumped out, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructed a whale to eat him, to take him in,
So the whale opened its mouth, and as he was in the water, battling probably with the water, the whale came in and big gulp, and he was in it. Now you can imagine, water must have gone in, he went in with it, and he was now in the belly of the whale, unconscious, lying there. And then he gets up after a while. And let's make mention of the verses. Allah makes mention, beautiful verses in the Quran.